Hi, good morning everyone. I hope you all are doing great job. You all are fine, you all are safe at your home. Same here, I'm also fine at my place. I'm just making videos for you people so that you will able to come to know about many grammar rules or the topics which are quite helpful to you as well in speaking and writing part as well. So today my topic is reported speech. Will not waste much time. Reported speech is a topic. What is reported speech? Reported speech is a speech which tells you about what someone has said. For example, you know that many quotations you are also using when your teacher is giving you any homework. You have to write quotations, or morning assemblies also. We are using in morning assemblies many quotations. So what are those basically? Do we change as per our convenience? No, we can't change. For example, I have just written three quotations for you, which I'm going to read. The very first quotation by Albert Einstein: the true sign of intelligence is not knowledge but imagination. Second is, be the change you want to see in the world. That's by Mahatma Gandhi. Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow know what you truly want to become. This by Steve Jobs. So quotations means in single inverted commas. You have seen many times also, without single inverted commas we are not writing quotations. Quotations always be in single inverted commas that we cannot change. So that's the reported speech. Now we have two things into it: direct speech and indirect speech. You will not get confused in anything. Rules are very important. According to the rule we have to do that. We have to change direct into indirect or indirect to direct. This we can see in our next slide. The very first is direct speech. As the word is telling, direct. What is direct? The direct speech is the mode of narration in which a speaker's words are presented using exactly the same words and are placed within quotation marks, which I have already given you three examples of it. Quotation marks, the and, as it is we have to write, or we have to speak as it is without changing a single word. So that is direct speech. Examples, two more examples I have written also. That Dr. Sami said, what Dr. Sami said, I love to do this work. This I am telling you that Dr. Sami said, I love to do this work, the same. What Dr. Sami said to me, I just conveying the same to you without changing anything. That is a direct speech. And quotations. That inverted commas, single inverted or the double inverted commas, that are very important. Then he said, I am glad to be here this evening. So what he said, that I am glad to be here this evening, as it is I am just speaking. So that's the direct speech which you cannot change. We have few rules of it, that in the sentences given below in the previous slide. You have to see the previous slide when I'm reading these sentences. The mode of the narration shows the speech as directly delivered by the speaker. The speech is directly delivered by the speaker, correct. Then the mode of narration is called direct speech. I already told you the speaker is mentioned. Yes, whether who spoke that line, the speaker is mentioned over here, either pronoun or the noun. Then when the speaker exactly said is given within quotation marks, single inverted commas or the double inverted commas, I told you that too. Then reported clauses and introducing verbs. These two are the new things which you have to see, what are reported clause and what are introducing verbs. Reported clauses, the word of the speaker within quotation marks, within the quotation marks we have few words. So that's the reported clauses. And introducing verbs, that is before the inverted commas. For example, Rahul said. So said, what is said, that is introducing verbs. Rahul told, what is told, introducing verb. She asked, Ask again is an introducing verbs. So this you need to see. I think I'm clearing with everything to you. If you have any doubts still, you can see my video again. Then next we have indirect speech. Direct speech that we cannot change, but indirect we can change as per our convenience. We can add into it something, we can change pronouns, we can change tenses, we can change many things that you can see in our next slides. So indirect speech, the mode of narration in which a person reports about the verbal communication, like I'm communicating with you. So what I'm doing over here, that is indirect speech. If I'm telling you about someone has said what, and though in single inverted commas, so that is direct speech. So here is indirect speech, the mode of narration in which a person reports about the verbal communication taking place between two or more people is known as indirect speech. The actual words of the speaker are not reported. Examples, Dr. Sami said that he loved to do his work. Here you can see the difference. I haven't used over here quotation marks, or I have used that in place of quotation mark. Yes. So this is indirect, that I am reading on my own, or I am writing on my own, or I am telling it on my own, that Dr. Sami said that he loved to do his work, and Dr. Sami has expressed his love for that work. So without inverted commas, and that we are free to change, that is indirect speech. Now this is very important. Now you see that my previous videos based on two grammar topics, the one pronouns and another one is tenses. So here we can revise also both of the things. We can revise side by side so that you will not forget. So here direct speech. When our direct speech is in simple present tense, that we need to change into simple past in indirect. For example, Rita said, Rita is a girl. So Rita said, I love my work. We know I love my work. Love is simple present. So that we have to change into simple past. That becomes loved. Rita said that. Rita is a girl. Then she, pronoun. She loved her work. Her again. Because Rita is a girl. She, her. So Rita said that she loved her work. Second is present continuous. Again present, then past. Present continuous, past continuous. I am loving, then she was loving. So Rita said, I am loving my work. Rita said that she was loving her work. Present perfect, again perfect will remain the same third form of the verb, right? So but present change into past. Present perfect change into past perfect. Present into past. Past continuous, again see, simple present, simple past. Present continuous, past continuous. Present perfect, past perfect. Simple past, past perfect. Past perfect, past perfect. So we have here three tenses which will only change into past perfect. The very first is present perfect, simple past and past perfect. I have just given you example of present perfect, that Rita said, I have finished my work. Past perfect, had finished her work. Simple past, Rita said, I finished my work. Same as above, because it will change into past perfect. Rita said that she had finished her work. Past perfect, if here also indirect you have past perfect, indirect it will remain the same. There will be no change. Then we have models, that we call models. So models can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, right? So these are the models. So in direct, if I have will, that change into would in indirect. Will, would, shall, should, may, might, can, could. Here we have example also of the same, that Rita said, I shall work. Rita said that she should work. Shall change into should. Rita's father said she can work. Rita's father said she could work. Can change into could. Next, exceptions are always be there. So in this also we have few exceptions. Please look towards that. If the tense introducing verbs are in simple present, if you're introducing verbs, I told you what are introducing verbs, says, told, then will say. So these are introducing verbs. So if the tense introducing verbs are in simple present or in simple future or in present perfect. So tense quoted speech means reported speech, that single inverted commas one, that will not change. The tense will not change. Rest you will change, pronouns also you will change, but not tense. Tense will remain the same. Few examples, we can see that. DS means direct speech, IS means indirect speech. These are the abbreviations which I have used. So Rita says I love my work, because says is simple present. So Rita says that she loves her work will not change. Why I have written she loves, because this is the rule of simple present tense with singular. She is singular, we have to use S or ES in simple present tense. Then Rita will say, this is simple future, again it will not make any difference. I loved my work, Rita will say that she loved her work. Then changing the forms of pronouns, as per the reported speech you have to change pronoun. This when you will read, then only you will come to know about it, that how I have also changed. And side by side I was just telling you even. Next is changing words denoting time, place and position. So here also we have few things, change of time, change of place, change of position. For example, ago. When you have in your reported speech ago and you have to change into indirect, so ago you have to change into before. Then here, there, this, that, last, previous, next means next day or the next week or the next year. So that you have to change following day, following week or following year. Now, then, these, those, today, that day, tomorrow. Again, tomorrow means following. So it will be following day or the next day. Then tonight, that night. Tonight, that night. Yesterday, the previous day. The day which has gone, the previous day or the day before. Here also few examples are there that Soma commented. The place looked so different 10 years ago. So ago you can see up. The very first is ago changed into before. So Soma commented that the place had looked so different 10 years before. Meenal said, my father saw an eye specialist yesterday. Then Meenal said that his father had seen an eye specialist the day before. Yesterday means the day before which has gone. So I think I have just covered everything to explain you. Rest you have to do more and more practice. You will search out many sentences. You have sentences in your books also. So according to it, you can do that. Do practice of the same. Thank you and have a nice day. Have a safe day. God bless you, all of you. Thank you once again for watching my video. And stay tuned for more videos, grammar videos.